Hello, my name is Johnny Verba, and I crave adrenaline. However, my family does not approve of this type of lifestyle, and they claim that cheating death is not a hobby, but I continue to disobey their every order.
Hey, Mom. So I've been doing some thinking. I think I'm going to hike Mount Kilimanjaro this summer.
Are you out of your f***ing mind?
How about you find a new hobby?
Oh, more gray hairs coming my way.
I guess the first thing I'd have to do is stop funding your 529 account effective May 20th. What else? And then probably take you out of the wheel too.
And just like that, my plane ticket was booked to Africa. That was what I pictured in my head. Turns out, going to Africa requires a heck of a lot more persuading, fundraising, training, planning, and packing before I could ever start the hike to reach the tallest point on the continent of Africa. And it all started at the Greek Leadership Village at Arizona State University.
Arizona Beta is a charter of Sigma Alpha Epsilon that has rich history, dating back to December 9th, 1961. In 2017, my dreams became reality when Arizona Beta came back to Arizona State University. Back in fall 2018, I received an email from national staff talking about Climb for a Cause, a climb of Mount Kilimanjaro in Tanzania. When I sent this link out to the chapter, Johnny showed interest right away. He really wanted to be a part of it, and he's the only one that went through with it in our chapter. There's nobody else I'd rather do it. He's got a AAA personality, he's a walking ball of energy, he's a great guy to represent Arizona Beta and SAE nationally. Bye, Alpha Johnny.
As soon as I read that text from Brandon, I was sold. But I knew my parents would strongly oppose this trip. It was gonna take some serious convincing. Turns out, all it took was two lions, my best friend Peyton, and a sign from God.
My name is Fi, and I have been guarding the left side of the GLV for about 1 year now. Johnny has more energy than a nuclear reactor, so I think he will be able to hike Mount Kilimanjaro no problem. My name is Alpha. I am Vi's twin brother, and I guard the right side of the GLV. I have already let Simba know that Johnny is on his way, so he is not on the menu.
Hi, I'm Peyton. I met Johnny this year over Instagram, and ever since then, he's just been my best friend. He makes so much of a difference in my life in so many different ways, whether it's with God or just him being crazy all the time. And yeah, he's crazy. I know that God will be with him in this hike, and I hope it's everything he wants and more.
What do you gotta say, John?
Do you have the car keys?
Go Devils!
Oh,
go Devils!
Yeah, get those jingles. Woo! Oh yeah!
With just 2 weeks left in my first semester at Arizona State University, brother Brandon Pike led our chapter, Arizona Beta, to the top of A Mountain for our last ritual ceremony of the semester. As we hiked A Mountain, the brothers' spirits were very high. Arizona Beta had been named Colony of the Year. This following semester, we had regained our charter. And most importantly, we had built a brotherhood that will never be broken. The whole group was living like John. And as we got to the top, we saw something that I will never forget. In this photograph, which was taken at the exact spot I sit right now,
we were able to see a group of Africans praising and praying to the Lord.
I am a firm believer in signs over science, and I know that seeing them on this day was a true sign from God that He is watching over my shoulder while I hike Mount Kilimanjaro in honor of John McNicholas. Now that everyone was on board with the plan, it was time to fund it. A thank you from the bottom of my heart to every single person that contributed towards my climb for a cause. That means the world to me and Live Like John. The trip's cost was $6,000, and that's not including flights, tips, or gear. Any amount over $6,000 was donated directly to Live Like John. The fundraising started on my birthday, May 1st, with a blast all over Instagram, Snapchat, and Facebook. And for my 19th birthday, I asked for donations towards my climb. There was our first $1,000. Later that week, our neighborhood was having their annual garage sale, so we were able to sell off some old memories in hopes to make some new ones. It was a 3-day sale, and we did fairly well, bringing us to $2,000. Then it was time to get down to business and start doing some cold calling. Soon we hit $3,000, climbing to $4,000, nearly at $5,000.
And now it's time for the 9th annual Live Like John softball tournament.
While Kilimanjaro is not an overly technical climb, it certainly is a full body workout. And I wanted to prepare my arms just as much as my legs. So I set out to tackle one of the world's most challenging workouts. Today is Memorial Day, and what better way to celebrate than completing the Murph Challenge? I'm here with my best friend, Frankie Shambora, who has just recently enlisted in the United States Marine Corps. So Frankie, what exactly is the Murph Challenge?
Well, Johnny, the Murph Challenge is 1 mile run, followed by 100 pull-ups, 200 push-ups, 300 squats, and then finish with another mile.
It is unpartitioned, so we will not be able to move on to the 100 pull-ups until we finish the mile and so forth. Michael Patrick Murphy was a United States Navy SEAL officer who was awarded the U.S. military's highest decoration, the Medal of Honor, for his actions during the war in Afghanistan. He was the first member of the U.S. Navy to receive the award since the Vietnam War. Murphy was killed on June 28, 2005, after he left his cover position and went to a clearing from the mountains, exposing himself to a hail of gunfire in order to get a clear signal to contact headquarters to relay the dire message and requesting immediate support for his team. He dropped the satellite phone after being shot multiple times, but picked the phone back up and finished the call. While being shot, he finally signed off, saying thank you, then continued fighting from his exposed position until he died from his wounds. I'd now like to take a moment of silence to thank the men and women who made the ultimate sacrifice protecting the United States of America. Thank you.
God bless America. Land that I love. Stand beside her.
Keep going.
Challenge 2019.
Let's go!
There turned out to be a literal tornado warning, so as soon as we finished the Murph, we had to book it right home. 58 minutes, right there. That is the final time. We got under an hour. That was our goal, so it was a challenge success. With the trip quickly approaching, I decided to hit the web to see exactly what I was getting myself into, as well as getting some vaccinations. Mount Kilimanjaro. Whoa, way too intense. Remember, Grandma and Grandpa are watching this video. We have to make this seem safe. Mount Kilimanjaro stands at a staggering 19,341 feet. Looking at the tallest peaks of every continent, Mount Kilimanjaro ranks the fourth highest. Of the some 30,000 people that attempt Mount Kilimanjaro every year, only about 10 die. Symptoms of altitude sickness may include difficulty sleeping, dizziness or lightheadedness, loss of appetite, shortness of breath with exertion, nausea or vomiting, rapid heart rate. Thankfully, Beyond Adventures, our tour company, has provided us a shots and immunizations list to keep us safe. We will be taking the Machami route, which is known for its breathtaking views and high level of acclimatization. By hiking high and sleeping low for the first couple of days, we will train our bodies and our brains to work on lower levels of oxygen. When we reach the peak of Mount Kilimanjaro, we will be breathing roughly one-third of our regular oxygen level. We will also be moving through four different climate zones: the jungle, moorland, alpine desert, and Arctic tundra. Perfect. Now that the grandparents have fallen asleep, we can fast forward to the juicy stuff. Alrighty, we are headed to the doctor's office with Dr. Cruz to get some
shots, everybody!
What shots are we getting today, Mom?
good. You got a little stage fright there.
Does Dr. Cruz have to touch me this time?
No, honey.
Okay, perfect.
It's cold in Illinois. I hate this state.
2 hours later.
That is the list. Loving up. Oh yeah! That's so scary.
I'm sorry.
1, 2, 3.
Ouch.
You guys are cracking me up.
So surprisingly, all we needed was one tetanus shot and a quick testy twist, and we were good to go.
Oh my god.
Just talk to moms, told her she the sweetest.
I love that song.
Good morning, Mom. What's for breakfast this morning?
Medicine. Here you go, honey.
Thanks, Mom.
Bon appetit.
Yummy. All right, so not every single medication can be taken via a shot at the doctor. So we have typhoid, something for a simple headache, diarrhea and stomach viruses. This one's for altitude sickness, malaria. And finally, last but not least, the most important pill of them all. This little bugger will transport me back to Geneva in case of an emergency.
Hailing from the great mountaineering state of Illinois, we already had a majority of the gear, so we only had to make 7 or 8 runs to our local outdoor store. Beyond Adventures gave us a great head start, providing us a comprehensive list of everything we would need to tackle Kilimanjaro.
Hey, excuse me, how you doing?
Hey man, what's
so,
up?
I'm hiking Mount Kilimanjaro this summer, and I've never really camped before, not much hiking experience. Do you think this is a good idea?
Yeah, man.
Finally, after months of preparation, it was time for Africa.
Welcome to Lego Mountain of Praise and Peace.
We have just started our journey from the Mountain of Praise and Peace. Now we are going to the Lego Primary School to do project work of painting classrooms for the children so that they can be transformed. From the day we arrive on the planet, and blinking step into the sun, there's more to see than can ever be seen, more to do than can ever be done. There's far too much to take in. To find them can never be found.
The service and smiles we were able to provide in Lake Ho Village was the single most rewarding experience of my life. And now, it was time to be closer to John than ever before. Our gear was checked one final time by our lead guide Samia, and we headed for the mountain.
Cole, the kid. Keith, the dad. Steve, the cop. Casey, the athlete. Brian, the fundraiser. Trevor, the boyfriend. Adele, the girlfriend. Grant, the uncle. Drew, the leader.
And myself, leading us up the mountain.
Kevin, the engine. Dennis,
Mr. Peace.
Mountain Lion. The animal, Dr. Samia. Nazareth sings a lot. Ahi, better than the fish.
And field expert, Mark the monkey.
At the Machami
gate. It's my time now.
Machami now.
With our group of just 10 climbers, we were able to employ nearly 50 porters.
We've been granted approval. All right,
starting us off. Here we go!
This was the point of the climb, when we realized just how grateful we were to not have been carrying our full mountain duffel bags on our heads. These are porters, and they are the ones that are carrying our gear as well as their gear to the top of the mountain. As we are hiking, the porters are taking down our camp from the night before, running past us on the trail and setting up camp while making lunch before we even get there. In accordance with Tanzanian law, each porter can only have 40 pounds or less on their heads. And that's not including the backpacks on their back or anything else they're carrying. Some porters can carry nearly their weight in gear. They are caretakers. They are singers. They are dancers. And they are the backbone of the mountain.
Day one, almost complete. We are out of breath at the very end, my friend. Yeah. And we have made it to camp with Uru Peak and the near background. Absolutely beautiful.
Day number two, we would be saying goodbye to the jungle as we entered the moorland. The vegetation was visibly shrinking all around us. Not only would we climb above the tree line, but the first blanket of clouds as well. Which meant we had to say our goodbyes to the dog-sized mosquitoes. As we escaped the thick canopy of the jungle, and were exposed to the intense rays of sunlight, we made a SPF 100 sunscreen stop.
Do a little tour here. This is where one can wash their hands, as you can see Brother Brian demonstrating, although there's not a bowl down there, but that's okay. Here is what we call the mess tent, where things get messy.
Yo, what's up?
Food and Drew stay warm in here. These tents are the highest of quality provided by Beyond Adventures Co. And this is the bathroom. How you feeling?
I'm okay.
Oh yeah, mountain lion.
Hi.
This is mountain lion. This is what is this? What is this tent called?
Chicken.
Yeah, chicken.
Woo!
What are we cooking up in here? Yes, yeah, man. Thank you so much, Asante.
Karibu.
Ooh, look at that.
Apple.
Oh yeah.
Kilimanjaro, fresh and chicken.
Day three was a haul across the moorland. We woke up at our usual 6:30 a.m. and started our hike at around 8. The winds were incredibly high all day long. And we were told to expect to feel like we were walking on Mars. We'll be right back. By the time we got to high camp, the winds had picked up at nearly 70 miles an hour. This was the first time the thought, "We paid for this?" came into our heads.
Ow.
Not only was the wind breaking the tent, it was breaking us. And to make matters even worse, we'd heard news over lunch that Steve was experiencing the early stages of a heart attack, so guides had to take him down the mountain to safety. Some of us seriously considered going home, but we decided to continue on. The mountain woke us up with a sleet storm.
Look at that!
Woo! Climbing the Bronco Wall would be extremely dangerous in slippery conditions, so we danced for Mother Nature.
We just finished a short sleet storm / hailstorm.
Fortunately, the weather subsided, and we began the climb up the 1,000-foot wall. Not showing love to this rock? Well, you could kiss your life goodbye. Reaching Karanga Camp was a huge milestone, because this was the last acclimatization camp, which meant it was only up from here. We danced our tails off, because the next sleepless 48 hours would be the most challenging of our lives. It was time to summit Mount Kilimanjaro. We got in our tents at 7 p.m. and our guides shook them at midnight. Not a single person fell asleep last night, either because of adrenaline or the fact that our resting heart rate was well over 100 beats per minute. Time seemed to slow down as we attempted to reach the roof of Africa at 19,341 feet, a full 3 miles in the freezing cold. So I started the hike off with a prayer.
Amen. All right. Pomoja, Pomoja.
Pomoja, Pomoja.
Day and night collided overhead. The sun and the stars met for the first time. If it weren't for this footage,
I would have never believed I was there.
After our successful summit attempt, we quickly descended 9,000 feet in elevation. We celebrated and slept, then prepared for tomorrow's final descent to the gate. As we made our way through the jungle, this iconic album cover worthy photo was taken. You can find Kilimanjaro Yes Papa streaming on all platforms now.
I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. Heart is yearning like a candle burning in the night. Seasons keep on turning, sometimes hard to keep up the fight. I will climb the ancient mountain, I will find the last flicker of the light. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. Oh yeah, I can see a new tomorrow. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. Oh yeah, I cast away all my sorrow. What a strange, strange freedom. Only free to choose my chains. So hard not to weaken. Just give up and walk away. I will climb the ancient mountain. I will find the last flicker of the light. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. Oh yeah, I can see a new tomorrow. Oh, turn me up. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. Oh yeah, I cast away all my sorrow. Me up. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. Oh yeah, it thrills me right down to the marrow. Oh, me up. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. I can see a new tomorrow. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. 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 I can see a new tomorrow. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. I cast away all my sorrow. Follow me up. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. It pulls me right down to the marrow. Follow me up. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. I can see a new tomorrow. Follow me up. I'm sitting on the top of Kilimanjaro. I can see a new tomorrow.
We were just feet away from finishing. And at this point, my brain was still remembering how to use oxygen properly. So my words were not exactly clear.
We sprinted the last 2 miles down the hill to victory because surprisingly, it is easier to run downhill than to walk. Here we are at the Mekami. So that the Mek, what did I say? What's the name of it? Mekwa? Mekwai? Gate. Here we are. Mweka. Mweka. Gotta get this.
Yeah. I'm done. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, we're that's perfect. It. We are done. Ow!
This is Mweka Gate. And we did a Kilimanjaro together with my two friends here.
Yes.
Yeah.